classes for us to practice at home. So let's go ahead and get started with our pre-level lesson two acro class. Roll it down.
Nine and ten. This layout here is going to lay down on your tummy. You're going to
press up and take both toes to the head. For one, open knees, two, three, four, and down, five. Good job. Okay, so that was the easy one. Now we're going to put our knees together, and this is going to be a little bit harder. Yeah? So sometimes you can take your hand in here, squeeze. Yep. Then we're going to press up nice and tall into our cobra. One, two, three, four. Beautiful. Five. And down. Keeping the knees closed together, she's going to press up with her right foot, taking that toe to her head. For one, knees together, two. Oops, knees together. Three, knees together. Four, and down. Five. Press up left foot to the head, squeezing your knees together for one, two, three, four, and five. Good. She's going to press up both toes to the head. For one, nice. Two, look at that. Three, four, and five. So push back into turtle pose. Yeah, so after all that arching, let's take a little bit of a rest. Good, coming back down onto our tummies. Going into boat pose. So our feet are to the corners of the mat. She's going to lift up. She's going to hold for one, two, three, four, five, six, seven. And she paddles up for one, two, up and down. Three, four, five, six, seven, and relax. Good. Okay, we're going to do that one more time. Lift up into boat pose, holding for one, tip toes, two, three, four, five, six, toes, seven, and paddle for one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, and relax. Good. This little is going to press up into her cobra. We're going to be doing assisted boat rocks. So she's going to do a boat rocks this time with her hands the entire time on the floor. Ready? Assisted boat rocks. She's going to keep her hands on the floor the whole time. She's going to rock. Go. One and down. Two and down. Three. We're going for five. Four. And last one. Five. Good. And then we're going to take a breather. And she's going to do that one more time. It's about repetition, right? Here we go.
Strong arms. If I push on them, they should move. Good. The feet are together.
She is going to pick up her right leg. We're going to hold for 10, 9, point those toes, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, other side, plus 1, 2, 3, put them down, 4, 5, here we go, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Those toes are too beautiful not to be pointed, right? Okay. I'm going to show you a mermaid lying down on the floor. So Layla's going to have a seat on her bum. Good. She is going to put her right foot in front, or your left, doesn't matter, as long as you do both sides. And her other leg around the back. Good. From here, she's going to walk her hands backwards, where she's lying down completely on the floor. Yes, mermaid on the floor. And then we're going to try to get this toe up into their elbows here. They're going to hold onto their knee, and they're not going to forget to point their bottom foot. So I'm going to bring the camera over here so you can see what this looks like from on top.
So this is what your mermaid on the floor looks like. Good.
Moving on to chin stands, one of Layla's favorites. We're going to come to the backs of your mats, up onto our knees, hands into the correct placing. They're rolling down, not trying to hold anything yet. We're working on our roll downs and coming back up. Yes, so we'll do this a couple of times. Go ahead. Just roll down. Roll down and come back up. Good. It's just getting them used to the movement. We're not working on holding any positions or putting any weight or pressure on any body parts yet. This is our technique section of the class. We're going to do some elbow kicks onto our elbows. Our ankles are together, knees are straight, and toes are pointed. We have 8 kicks on the right and 8 kicks on the left. Going a little bit faster than last week, but still not quite as fast. We want to focus on knees and feet. Ready? 8 times. 1 and 10. 2 and down, 3 and down, 4 and down, 5 and down, 6, 7, 8, left leg goes 1 and 2 and 3 and 4, look at her legs, they're beautiful, 5, 6, 7, last one, 8, good job, nice, thank you, Layla. We're going to do our drill next. We're going to bring our knees close together. Squeezing our booties, putting our hands right here. We're going to keep a straight line with our torso. We're not going to be arching back. Okay, we're going to stay straight with our head. We're going to lean back as far as we can and come back up. I would usually do this 10 times in class. Today we're going to do 5. Ready? 1 and up. Don't take it like that. We need 2 and up. 3. 2 more. 4. And last one, 5. So these are your knee hinges. And now we're going to take our mat and go up against the wall. First, we're going to go ahead and do our headstands. So you have your students go ahead and put their head on the mat and their hands in front of them. Okay, walking our feet up on the wall into our headstand. Our ankles are going to go together, straight legs. Get those feet up higher. Straight legs, lift your booty up. Lift your booty up. Good. We're going to hold this for 1, 2, 3, 4, and she's going to take her right leg off the wall for 1 straight knee, point the toe, 2, 3, 4, and our left leg lifts, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Come on down. We are moving on to elbow stands. She's going to come onto her elbows this way. Good. She's going to look ahead and keeping her head off of the floor. Look forward. Good. Big spider hands. Walking your feet up on the wall. Ankles are together. We hold for 1. Straight legs. 2, 3, 4, and 5. One foot comes off the wall for 1, 2, 3. Nice. 4. And left foot. 1, 2, 3, 4. And down. Handstands. We're going to put our hands in front of us. Straight arms. We're going to walk our feet up onto the wall. Legs are straight, ankles are together. We hold for 1, 2, 3, 4, and right foot's going to come off straight, pointed. 2, 3, 4, and left foot comes off. 2, 3, 4, and come on down. Good. Tracking across the floor, forward rolls. For those of you who are hands on the floor, tuck your chin into your chest, rolling, pulling all the way around. one partnering skill every month. Last month, I believe, was the triangle, the pyramid. This month is your shoulder stand. So you're going to stand. And again, this is not a how-to, remember. This is not a how-to tutorial. This is our lesson. Yeah? So she's going to step. One, two, three, all the way up. Stand up nice and tall. Right? Left. Come back to you. Is it going to go all the way? If you can, if you're feeling really confident, they can let go of one hand. Can you let go of the other? Okay, she says she's gonna fall. So since we don't have a mirror in the studio, I can't see what's happening. I will take her word for it. But try to take both hands off and let go and fall, yes? And when you do that, the base is just gonna hold onto the flyer's calf muscles. On three, she's gonna jump in front of me. One, two, she jumps. We always end our lessons with deeper stretches since your body is warmer towards the end of the class. We're going to come onto our knees, and this is when we are going to teach a lunge. Lunge is for some reason, a confusing and difficult thing to teach your kids. We're going to put our right leg forward. So you come onto your knees, right leg. Hands on both sides of your foot. We're going to tuck our back leg and straighten it. This is called a lunge. We're going to hold here for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and step it in. Switch legs. For 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good job. All right. We're going to have a little bit of a seat on the bum. We're going to do a straddle. So, again, we did this earlier, but now we go a little bit deeper because it's in the class. So I'm going to walk around and really press everybody deeper into their stretches. We're going to point our feet. Make sure our bum is squeezed. Take our nose over to our right leg. For 10, 9, 8, no big toes on the floor. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and other side. For 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, focus nose, 5, 4, 3, 2, down the center. For 1, 2, good, lay low as far as you can. 3, 4, the world is watching you. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, she's really pushing herself here. And lay low comes on up. Good job, stretch it out. Last thing we're going to be showing you are our splits. We're going to swing up onto our knees. Then we're going to put our right leg forward. So we're keeping our hips nice and square. Hands slide all the way down into our splits. Good. I am terrified to see what my split looks like. There we go. She's going to hold it. Hold. As many of you guys saw in the last few tutorials, I was super pregnant, just had a baby. Now battling a little bit of a hernia. So I haven't been doing as many stretching as I should be. Good. And switch to the other side onto our knees. Left leg comes forward. She's going to slide all the way down, keeping this toes pointed. And relax. Thank you guys so much for watching. I really appreciate it. And we'll see you next week for Acro Lesson 3.